Now we are discussing negative time exponential sequence. That sequence should be what? It is of infinite duration. Okay. In the previous case, we discussed positive time exponential sequence, that too of infinite duration. Now we are dealing negative time exponential sequence. This sequence should be of infinite duration. Let us consider a negative time exponential sequence is defined by x of n equal to minus b to the power n u of minus n minus 1. Then Z transform of the sequence x of n is given by, let us write the definition of Z transform, x of z equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n z to the power minus n. So this is what it is, the definition of Z transform. Now in this definition, I am going to substitute the value of x of n, that is x of z is equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n is given, that is I am going to substitute, that is minus b to the power n u of minus n minus 1 multiplied by z to the power minus n. Fine, but what is the value of u of here? We know that u of minus n minus 1, it is a step signal. In that step signal, some operation is performed, that is shifting as well as reflection. So of course we are getting amplitude 1, but for what time? So time is what? If the value of n is less than or equal to minus 1, then we are getting amplitude 1, else it is 0. So it means we can write this one as, we are having amplitude 1 for u of minus n minus 1. We are having amplitude 1 for which range? The value of n should be less than or equal to minus 1. So that one we can write, the range of n lies between minus infinity to minus 1. The range of n lies between minus infinity to minus 1. So if we are replacing this term by 1, if we are replacing this term by 1, by amplitude 1, then we have to change the limits as minus infinity to minus 1. So I am going to write x of z is equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to minus 1. This minus term, I will take it outside. Here it is minus b to the power n, and this is replaced by 1, of course, then z to the power minus n. Okay, so this kind of example already we discussed. So I can simplify this one as minus as it is, summation n equal to minus infinity to minus 1, b by z to the power minus 1, one thing, but 1 by z, b by z to the power n. Okay, then it is difficult to simplify because here, observe here, minus infinity to minus 1 is there. There is no standard summation formula for this one. So because of that reason, I'm going to reindex. I'm going to substitute. Let us take n equal to minus m. If I take n equal to minus m, minus m equal to minus infinity. Minus minus get cancels, m equal to infinity. Here also, this is n equal to minus 1 is there. If I substitute here, in the upper limit, n equal to minus m means minus m equal to minus 1, minus minus get cancels. So upper limit becomes m equal to 1. So if you rearrange this one, always we have to write limits from lower to lower value to higher value. Hence, we can write minus as it is, summation m equal to 1 to infinity, 1 to infinity, this one, b by z to the power term, n equal to what we taken? Minus m we taken. Okay, then further step, minus as it is, summation m equal to 1 to infinity, this one we can write like this, b by z to the power minus 1 raised to m. Okay, then next step is x of z is equal to minus as it is, summation m equal to 1 to infinity, here b by z to the power minus 1, nothing but 1 divided by b by z. 1 divided by b z means we can write z by b to the power term m. Okay, fine. Here 0 to infinity we have formula, but here 1 to infinity is there. Because of that reason, what I am doing, I am making this correction. I am adding 1 and subtracting 1. There is no change in the result. Adding 1 and subtracting 1. There is no change in the result. Why I am doing this step means, simple thing, observe here, if I substitute m equal to 0 here, in this, if I substitute m equal to 0 means, anything raised to 0, 1. So that 1 is indicated by this one. Nothing but here I will write summation z divided by b raised to 0. Nothing but what we are getting? We are getting 1. When it is 0, if you substitute m equal to 0, nothing but it is for what? For m equal to 0. It is for what? M equal to 0. So this one we can write summation at m equal to 0 z by b raised to m is equal to what? 1. So this one is nothing but this one. So here 1 to infinity is there, here 0 is there. So togetherly I will write this one as x of z is equal to minus as it is summation m equal to 0 to this one common. Sorry, here I have taken common minus. Okay, now 0 to infinity z by b to the power m minus 1 as it is. So for the simplification, multiply this minus to the terms which are present in the square bracket. That is x of z is equal to minus into minus plus plus 1 minus summation m equal to 0 to infinity z by b to the power m. So this one we can simplify by using the formula. That is summation m equal to 0 to infinity, a to the power m. This one we can write 1 divided by 1 minus a, if and only if the mod of a is less than 1. Here what? Here a equal to z by b. Now simplify this one. X of z is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by 1 minus z by b. So what is LCM? LCM is b. For the simplification, x of z is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by b minus z divided by b. So for the simplification, we can do here like this. It will go to the numerator. That is x of z is equal to 1 minus b divided by b minus z. So once again, LCM is what? B minus z. So that is x of z is equal to b minus z minus b divided by b minus z. Now this plus b minus b get cancels. Hence x of z is equal to minus z divided by b minus z. So let us multiply the numerator and denominator by minus 1. Hence we are getting x of z equal to z divided by z minus b. It is what? It is our z transform for the negative time exponential sequence. Fine, we calculated z transform. Let us go for sketching ROC on the z plane. Very simple. Remember here, we got this z transform, we got this answer when by using this summation formula. This summation formula is valid only when if mod of a is less than 1. Here a equal to what? Z by b, nothing but mod of z by b is less than 1. That one I'm going to write here. It is ROC. Mod of z by b is less than 1. If you take b towards other side, that is we can write mod of z is less than mod of b. This is our ROC. Fine. We calculated ROC and we calculated z transform. Next, go for calculating the poles and zeros. First, I will calculate zeros. Nothing but very simple. As I told earlier, equating the numerator polynomial to the zero will give the zeros. So only one term is there. That is, I will write z1. Equate numerator to the zero. That is z equal to zero. It means one zero is present at the origin. Okay. Next, go for poles. Equating the denominator polynomial to the zero, only one term is that is p1 equal to z minus b is equal to 0. That is, b take it other side, z equal to b. Nothing but one pole is present on the z plane where at the point b. Here 1, 0 is present on the z plane where at the origin. Similarly, one pole is present on the z plane at the point b. So let us sketch all these things on the z plane. Now I am going to sketch here all these values. Okay. Vertical axis, horizontal axis. Vertical axis indicates the imaginary part of z plane, and horizontal axis represent real part of z plane. Okay. Next. So what is the ROC here? ROC is what? The ROC lies inside the circle of radius d. So first we have to draw a circle on the z plane having radius b. So on the z plane, so this is our z plane. On the z plane, I drawn one circle of the radius b. But what is ROC? ROC, it indicates that mod of z is less than b. Less than b means inside this circle of radius b. So nothing but here inside the circle. This is shaded part will give the ROC. It is our ROC, shaded part. So ROC lies inside the circle of radius b. Fine. As well as we calculated zeros. One zero is present where? At the origin, this point. Zero is indicated by here zero. Zero at origin. Fine. Next, coming to the poles. How many poles are there? Only one pole. Where poles are indicated by cross mark. This is what this indicates. Pole. Pole at z equal to b. So now we calculated z transform for the negative time exponential sequence. Then we calculated ROC. This is z transform. This is ROC. Then we calculated zeros and poles. All these things we represent on the z plane. Okay.